मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? वेलकम बैक टू योर ईवीएस ऑनलाइन क्लास। चिल्ड्रेन, इन द लास्ट क्लास आई गिवन सम होमवर्क फॉर यू। डिड यू राइट एंड स्टडी देयर आंसर्स? यस, वेरी गुड। फर्स्ट वन, डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन ए रूट सिस्टम ऑफ ए कोकोनट ट्री एंड ए मैंगो ट्री। Distinguish between a root system of a coconut tree and a mango tree. Answer is, a coconut tree has fibrous roots grow from the base of the stem. Students know that this answer. Yes, a coconut tree has fibrous roots grow from the base of the stem, but a mango tree has a tap roots rises from the base of the stem. A mango tree has which types of roots? Yes, mango tree has a tap roots rises from the basis of the stem, and that roots goes deep into the soil. Second one, what are the uses of stem? What are the uses of stem? Who knows this answer? Do you know? Yes, say loudly. Yes, to eat, to produce young plants, to make medicine, to make furniture, to extract oil, etc. What are they? To eat, to produce young plants, to make furniture, to extract oil, to make newspaper, etc. Third one, what are the functions of stem? Write any three functions. Do you know answer? Yes, what is the answer? Say loudly. Yes, to keep most plants upright. Stem keep most plants upright. To support leaves. A stem carry food from leaves to all parts of the plants. Last one, what is photosynthesis? Who knows this answer? What is photosynthesis? What students know this answer? Yes, the process of preparing food using carbon dioxide, water and minerals is called photosynthesis. What students can understand these answers? Students, do you have any doubt? No. Yes, very good. Today we are learning about plants without chlorophyll. Children, do you know? Are there any plants without chlorophyll? Yes. Some plants do not have chlorophyll. Some plants do not have chlorophyll. For example, mushroom, bread mold, yeast, and ghost plant, etc. These plants are called non-green plants. Some plants do not have chlorophyll are called non-green plants. What are called non-green plants? Some plants do not have chlorophyll are called non-green plants. Example for? Yes, mushroom, bread mold, and yeast, ghost plant, etc. Next, I say about fruits for all. Do you like fruits, children? Do you like fruits? Which fruits do you like most? Which fruits do you like most? Yeah. Children, take your EVS textbook and look page number 10. Identify the given fruits. Can you see some fruits are there? Yes. First one, which fruits? This one. Yes. Guava, orange, apple, banana, jackfruit, pineapple and mango. What are there? Guava, orange, apple, banana, jackfruit, pineapple and mango. Children, do you know how are these fruits formed? How are these fruits formed? Yes, fruits are produced only by flowering plants. Fruits are produced only by flowering plants. Plants make food. Plants make food. They use the food to grow and live. Plants make food. They use the food to grow and live. Plants use the food to grow and live. The rest of the food is stored in fruits, stems and roots. The rest of the food is stored in fruits, stems and roots. Where do we get food from? Children, where do we get food? Yes, we get food from plants. Where do we get food from? Yes, we get food from plants. We use stems, roots, leaves, fruits, seeds of plants as food. We use stems, roots, leaves, fruits, seeds of plants as food. We eat some parts of a plant which we use for food. Root, carrot, beetroot, sweet potato, ginger, tapioca, etc. Then stem, colocasia stem, lotus stem, sugar cane. Then leaves, drumstick leaves, curry leaves, green leafy vegetables. Green leafy vegetables. Then fruits, mango, jackfruit, apple, orange. Seeds, rice, wheat and pulses. Once again I say root, carrot, beetroot, sweet potato, ginger, tapioca, stem, colocasia stem, lotus stem and sugar cane. Leaves, drumstick leaf, curry leaf, green leafy vegetables. Then fruits, mango, jackfruit, orange, etc. Then seeds, rice, wheat, pulses. Rice, wheat and pulses. Where do we get food from? Yes, we get food from plants. Some parts of a plant we use for food. Some parts of a plant we use for food. We use means we use stems, roots, leaves, fruits, seeds of plants as food. Then, which is the most attractive part of a plant? Yes, flower is the most attractive part of a plant. What makes it attractive? Because of its color, smell, shape and size. Because of its color, smell, shape and size. Children, take your EVS textbook and look page number 10. This is the homework for you. Which is the most attractive part of a plant? What makes it attractive? Okay? Make a list of common flowers means rose, lily, marigold, sunflower, ixora, jasmine, he discussed, etc. What are the maker list of common flowers? This is the answer for you. For example, rose, sunflower, hibiscus, lily, jasmine, ixora, and marigold. Children, take your EVS textbook and page number 11. Make a list of common flowers. Make a list of common flowers. This is the homework for you. Make a list of common flowers means write any name of flowers. Rose, sunflower, lily, lotus, jasmine. Flowers grow into fruits. Flowers grow into fruits. Fruits have seeds and seeds grow into plants. Flowers grow into fruits. Fruits have seeds and seeds grow into plants. Then I say about seeds for new plants. Seeds for new plants. Cut open a papaya fruit. Can you see? This is the picture. Yes. What can you see inside? What can you see inside? Yes. Fruits have seeds inside them. Fruits have seeds inside them. Some fruits have one seed, but some fruits have many seeds. Some fruits have one seed means mango, plum, cashew nut, coconut, etc. Some fruits have many seeds or fruits with more seed, papaya, watermelon, jackfruit and pomegranate. Plants give nature the beautiful green color. They give us food and fresh air. Plants give us food and fresh air. They are inevitable for life. Plants are inevitable for life. Inevitable means anivaryamayathu. They are inevitable for life. We should protect plants. We should protect plants. We should be thankful to them. We should be thankful to them. Once again I say, plants give nature the beautiful green color. They give us food and fresh air. They are inevitable for life. We should protect plants and we should be thankful to them. Here are one question. We should be thankful to plants. Give reason. Or why should be thankful to plants? What is the answer? Do you answer? Yes, say loudly. Yes, plants give nature the beautiful green color. Plants give us food and fresh air. We should protect plants. So we should be thankful to plants. We should be thankful to plants. Give reason. Answer is, plants give nature the beautiful green color. Plants give us food and fresh air. We should protect plants. So we should be thankful to plants. Students, do you understand about this answer? Why should be thankful to plants or we should be thankful to plants? Give reason. Do you have any doubt? Yes, very good. Children, now I give some homework for you. Write in your EVS notebook. We should be thankful to plants. Give reasons. We should be thankful to plants. Give reasons. Next, let's collect. Collect pictures of fruits and seeds and make a picture album. Or collect pictures of fruits and seeds. Paste in your EVS collection book. Okay.
Now I wind up this class. I hope you can understand this class. If you have any doubt, you can ask through WhatsApp. Thank you.